Some websites may require you to register to use them, such as sites you pay to use or sites where you can post content. For instance, on Kijiji.ca, you cannot post an ad until you've registered. If you try to post an ad by clicking on Post Ad without first registering, it'll take you to this page. If you've already registered to use the site, it means that you have an account on the site and you can click on Sign In. Once you sign in, the website will know who you are. If you're not already registered, you'll need to click on Register and make a new account, where you'll be asked to fill out an online form. Typically, you'll see a series of text entry boxes on online registration forms. Just click on a box and type into it. If you're using a phone or tablet, the on-screen keyboard will pop up when you tap a text box. Text boxes are often set to autocomplete. That means they guess what you're going to type, based on what you or other people have typed in the past. When an autocomplete menu appears, take a look at the suggested options and save yourself some typing by clicking or tapping on a selection if appropriate. If none of the options are what you want, go ahead and finish what you are going to type. To register for most websites, the form will ask you to enter your email address. Government sites may request more information, such as your social insurance number. Before you enter sensitive information on an online form, ensure the website is legitimate. See our Keeping Yourself Safe, Avoiding Online Scams video to learn more about confirming a website's validity. If you don't have an email address, you can register with a free webmail service like Outlook or Gmail. See our Setting Up an Email Account video for instructions on how to do that. When you sign up for an account, you'll usually get an email making sure that the address you use to register belongs to you. If you get an email like this, only click on the link if you've just registered for that site. If you haven't, the email is probably a scam. Our Keeping Yourself Safe, Avoiding Online Scams video has more information on how to spot and avoid email scams like this. A lot of websites will also ask you for your name, and nearly all will ask you to choose a password. Some sites ask you to use your real name, while others permit the use of a nickname or handle that other users will see instead. If you aren't required to use your real name, try a nickname or something else that doesn't identify you personally to protect your privacy. If the name you want is taken, you can make it yours by adding a word or number to the name that you'll remember. It may take a couple of tries. When you get one that works, write it down, then choose a password. You can learn more about setting a strong password in our Keeping Your Devices and Accounts Safe, Pins and Passwords video. For now, just remember to choose a password that uses a combination of letters and numbers that won't be easy to guess. Some online forms, like this online ordering system for a pizza restaurant, offer only certain options to choose from. Sometimes you can choose more than one option, like in the list of possible pizza toppings. And sometimes you can pick only one, such as with the list of delivery options. Sometimes there are so many text fields that you have to use a scroll bar to read them all. To do that, click or tap on the bar and then slide the mouse or your finger downward. If your mouse has a wheel on top, you can turn that instead. To change what's in a text field, just click or tap it and make your corrections right up until you click the Submit, Register, or Next button. To change a checkbox, you may have to uncheck your selection before you can check a different box. Sometimes, picking something new will change your choice automatically. If you realize that you made a mistake after clicking the Submit button, look to see if the form has a Back or Edit button, instead of using the browser's Back button. This way, you're less likely to lose information you've already entered. Sometimes, you may want or need to upload a file from your computer. For instance, on Kijiji, if you want to post an ad to sell your car, you'd click Select Images and then find an image of your car on your computer. Click Open and your photo will be uploaded to the website. Finally, on some websites, you may encounter a simple challenge meant to ensure that it's a real person using the website and not a computer program. In one common example, you may be shown a series of images. and be asked to select the ones that match a description. In this case, you're asked to choose images that include a vehicle. If you find that the images are not clear enough to complete the challenge, refresh the image set by clicking or tapping the circular arrow. You can do this as many times as you need. You can also click or tap the headphones to switch to an audio test. In this case, you'll hear a series of spoken words or numbers and be asked to enter them into a text box. For more information on online basics, check out the other videos in the series. Visit our website at telus.com/wiseonlinebasics.